It's warm and it's cozy.
Hello my friends, welcome back to this channel. The plan was actually to come here with Freya in 2 days and we were supposed to be here for 3 days. But Freya has her heat, or she's in heat, or yeah, she got a dog period. So I don't want to bring her in the woods right now. There's wolves in this area and at home the dogs go crazy when they see her, so I bet wolves would do that as well. I will do an overnighter today. I'm also gonna do a review on a pair of pants, actually. It's skiing pants, which I usually don't use out in the woods like this. But I have some plans to go to northern Sweden early next year. And this might come in handy when the temperature is down to minus 20, 30 degrees Celsius. And you can find a link in the description below if you find these pants to your liking. I will get 15% of each purchase, so it will help this channel out quite a lot. Great! The pants comes from Hardland. Looks like this. And yeah, I will use them during the day, during the evening, and tomorrow in the morning. The color is deep hemp gray. They are also breathable, waterproof, and windproof, which will really help out a lot during the coming winter. Well, that's enough talk for now. Let's get changed and get some spruce branches. Supposed to have hand warming pockets, and I guess it's these ones. It's quite cozy. Let's see if they are waterproof. I hope they're not lying, because I only have one pair of pants underneath this one with me. We'll see. So far so good. I'm actually starting to be really sweaty right now, so I will remove these pants and use them later tonight.
Nice. Was actually quite a long time ago I ate pea soup. Nothing fancy, but it is something we do each Thursday in the armed forces.
Don't know if you can see me, but I hope so. I'm inside. It's warm and it's cozy.
So nice. Good morning, my friends. Wonderful morning. Just came in from a morning wee. I restarted the fire. The night's been perfect. I've been very warm and comfortable. It's about 7:15 now or something. And yeah, I'm just waiting for the sun to go up.
We usually have a bucket close by with water in it, and this is usually dipped in the bucket, so let's say 10 liters of water with this one inside of it. I have water about 20 meters away from here, and I have a lot of snow, so I can use whatever, it will work. And now I have this tea, I will use that. And I would soak this in water. Like this. And then you... slap the fire like that. And you can see already, it stopped burning. I would have to slap more, but I want to be able to restart this fire, because I'm gonna have this fire for longer than this. But as you see, it works quite fast, just a couple of smashes and the fire is out. Now, this is not for the fireplace, this is for the shelter. So let's say something in the shelter starts burning. You have this and some water close by. Pour the water on top of the spruce branches and then start slapping. Okay? And the long one. Let's say the fire is something where you can't reach it. In this case, on the roof. I would use this long one with water on it to reach the places and start to slap. Okay? Bushcraft fire extinguisher. It's approved technique which we use in the Swedish Armed Forces. Okay then, the last thing I wanted to do before ending this video is just talk a little bit more about these pans. They've been great this trip. They've been warm, they have been cozy for sure. I've been using them while bushcrafting, carrying stuff, sewing stuff, sitting by the fire, and yeah, they held up, not a scratch on them, which is really good. However, when using pans like this in an outdoor situation like this, I would recommend to have something over them. I have a pair of snow pants, really thin one, that I will use on top of this one when I'm using this on trips further on. They were waterproof, at least now. I can't tell you how good of water protection will be still there in like a couple of months or a year or so, no clue. But yesterday when I tried it, they were waterproof. They seem to be breathing because I'm warm, but I'm not sweating in them. And yeah, I really like this pair of pants actually. I do have a side thing here, which I can open, I can tighten, I can loose it. And I can actually hang my knife in this one as well, which is perfect for me. I have two pockets right here. They are not insulated. And yeah. I also have two pockets up here. They are insulated. They are much warmer and cozier for sure. That's nice. And I have two back pockets as well. Not insulated, but it seems like there's some kind of water protection in this pocket, which is nice. This is my first review of something, of anything. I hope you enjoyed it during this trip. And I hope the company I'm reviewing it for also approve of this review. I will have to look at it when I get home and see how it actually became. But as I said, really happy with the pants. I will have the link in the description. Thank you, Hardland, for sending me these pants. And thanks to you all who buy these pants. Great, let's end this video, guys. Whew! If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like and subscribe, and check out my other videos at Adam Arrow Outdoors. Share it if you want to, that would be much appreciated, and hit that bell button for notifications to never miss out on a video. If you want to see behind the scene content, pictures from my trips and sneak peeks from my future videos, then go ahead and check out my Facebook and Instagram accounts. If you want to support me and join me on this journey, I recently opened up a Patreon account, so go ahead and check that out. All the links will be in the description below. That was it for today. I really hope to see you back in the next one. Until then, take care and stay safe.